Welcome back to the Island 54 Devlog. Today I invite you to join me as I develop my game's crafting system. Last episode, I showed you how I built a basic infantry system. In today's episode, I'll be adding two new tools to the game, a stone hand axe and a stone chisel. First, I'll make the new models. Then I'll go into a bit more detail about how I go about developing user interfaces. And then I'll develop an extensible crafting system that I'll build out over the next couple of episodes. Lastly, I'll give you a demo of the end result. As always, there'll be timestamps in the description below. I wanted the player to have a choice of two tools to craft, so I made both a hand axe and a stone chisel. For the hand axe, I started with the flat stone wedge I already had and changed it to have sharp edges. I was worried it was going to be too hard to tell apart from the original stone, so I put a second lighter material along the blade edge to make it look hardened. I made the chisel from scratch, starting from a cylindrical mesh and using loop cuts to get the shape the way I wanted it. Next, I needed the crafting UI, so as always, I started out by mocking up a dialog. Whenever I'm making simple non-web UIs, I tend to use the Model View Presenter, or MVP, architecture. In MVP, you have a model representing the data that the user will interact with, a view that's responsible for laying out the data and intercepting user input, and you have a presenter, which is where all the logic lives. It looks after reconfiguring the view and making stuff happen in response to user actions. In this case, my model is just a list of recipes. I've made each recipe involve a single input material, a tool, and an output object. Later, we might need multiple inputs to make more interesting recipes, but since we only have two infantry slots at the moment, this will meet my needs. I created a recipe for each of my new stone tools. I like to make an interface for my views so that I can more easily reason through what operations the view needs to support. In this case, it needs to be told what the list of available recipes is, and which recipe to show more details of in the right-hand panel. The view's implementation needs references to the various bits of the UI, and just wires up the model to those various UI components. Some people like to put this logic in the presentation layer, but I find it neater to put it in here. That way I can add stuff to the UI later, like including icons in the recipe list or labels for the ingredients, without having to change both the view and the presenter. Which brings us to implementing the presenter. It sets up the initial configuration of the view, then anytime someone clicks a recipe in the recipe selector, we reconfigure the view for that recipe. When someone clicks the crafting button, it triggers an external function to allow the item to actually be crafted. Now that we have what appears to be a working crafting interface, it's time to integrate it with the interaction system. I created a new action called Craft With, which I added to the round stone. The Craft With code has functions to let it decide which recipes are available to the player within their current context. When the interaction system is working out which actions should be shown, it checks if there is at least one recipe available. Then, if the user chooses the craft option, we pop up the crafting UI by creating the presenter and asking it to show its view. It passes the list of available recipes in, and also a function that will perform the actual crafting by removing the input material and replacing it with the newly crafted item. While I'm pretty happy with the end result here, it feels like there's something missing. Crafted items will obviously have stats like durability and quality later, and I think I might like the quality stat to be not only driven by the character's skill level, but also some element of skill from the player. I might try playing around with some sort of crafting minigame at some point and see how that works out. But this week's comment of the week comes from NuoGame, who cautions against putting too much effort into my interaction system. NuoGame is absolutely right here. If you're making a game and you get bogged down in detail like an interaction system, you're never going to get your game built. The goal in last week's episode was to get the interaction system to a point where I could get this crafting system off the ground. It also lets me experiment with what I think is a brand new take on infantry systems that I want to try out that stays true to my hyper-realism goal, but hopefully isn't annoying for the player. I can see plenty of problems with my current interaction system, but I'm intentionally leaving it as is for now, otherwise I'll spend weeks perfecting it, and it will start hindering my prototyping efforts rather than supporting them. So if you enjoyed this episode, be sure to leave a thumbs up. If you didn't enjoy it but stayed to the end anyway, then be sure to leave a mean comment down below. Next week, I'll be adding trees and a new resource gathering mechanic to the game. Until then, happy game developing!